Londoners take their buses so much for granted nowadays that they'd only notice them if they weren't there. Every year, more than 1,890 million people travel on buses, in and out of town, along 350 routes that cover 4,700 miles. If you knew only a fraction of these, you really would know London. And you'd have a fairly sound knowledge of Londoners as well. There are quicker ways of getting round, but there's no better place for soaking up London than the front seat on top of a double-decker bus. Buses have been part of the London scene for more than 100 years. You can trace their history in London's Museum of British Transport at Clapham, the largest museum of its kind in the world. Here you can see the changes that time has brought. It was in 1829 that the first public bus appeared on the London streets. This was a brightly coloured affair, drawn by three horses, romantic and exciting, but frankly not as reliable as you could wish, because the horses were as liable as humans to the failings of fatigue and boredom. With passengers on the increase, space became a problem. Someone hit on the idea of putting the public on the roof, and the double-decker was born. An unimpeded way to see the sight, which has been popular ever since. As London grew and became more industrialised, the city's traffic problems began. Horses were not quite up to rush hour travel, and there were traffic jams then that would be hard to beat. But it wasn't till 1897 that the first motor bus was licensed. Then, within a generation, all the horses which had held their own unchallenged for nearly 70 years had been dismissed, leaving their power to the new engines. But it's not only museum pieces which get the beauty treatment. Buses in use are given every care and attention. There's an enormous maintenance shop for buses where their health is looked after, where they're cleaned and polished and made to look gleaming. They get the whole works. They're disemboweled. The body is lifted off the chassis, the parts checked and repaired, and the two halves fitted together again with the greatest ease. The chassis and the body are indeed interchangeable with those of other buses. After this, you might think that they'd be ready for the road, but buses must be more than ready. They're tested to show that they can be tilted on their side to over 30 degrees and still be stable. Safe as houses, they say, but you could say safe as buses. The driver is made just as safe as his bus by thorough training at one of the many bus schools. And he's put through severe tests under all normal road conditions, as well as on the spectacular and highly geared skid patches. If you can cope with that, you can cope with anything. But a request from a passenger brings a gentler stop. The big red route masters are usually as dignified as a duchess's carriage, though she wouldn't be able to watch the landmarks go by as comfortably. Marble Arch, Regent Street, Piccadilly Circus, they wheel majestically by. And as you go, you might spare a thought for the clatter of hooves that started the whole business back in 1829.